In Cumberland County, the 7 students burned in the fire at Wilson Middle School are all out of the hospital, but the recovery's just beginning. News 8's Cumberland County reporter Matt Barcaro sat down with the parents of one of the victims today.
After all Brian and Judy Yin have been through this past week, they still don't know the answer to a basic question. How did their son Justin get so badly burned?
It's difficult for him to talk about it. We're not pushing him. But, you know, we'll just keep looking out for him, watching him.
Justin is a straight-A 8th grader at Wilson Middle School in Carlisle. This is his class picture. He likes playing table tennis and is an independent kid. But now he is depending on his parents to help him through a trauma his family could never have imagined.
He wakes up in the middle of the night, and I know he's had nightmares. It's difficult for him to get rest, get sleep through the night.
As you can see, second-degree burns covered Justin's face and ears. He was huddled around a classroom lab table watching a science experiment last week when it caught fire. His eyelids burned and both hands blistered.
Difficult. Yeah. It's definitely very difficult. You wish it would be you rather than him. And we just want to make sure that all the other kids that are involved are recovering as well, and
no
make sure
family have to go through
this.
Like that.
Yeah.
Justin's parents say Justin is getting better each day. He's passing the time by watching movies and playing some games. The doctor told them a full physical recovery could take a year, and then there's the emotional one. Justin won't be back in school for at least another week, and while he talks and texts with friends, he hasn't allowed them to see him.
He's not ready.
He's just not ready to get any visitors yet, yes.
The Yens say their neighbors, family, friends, and the school principal have all been there for them, and they'll rely on that support until their son is comfortable again. In North Middleton Township, Matt Barcaro, News 8.
Justin's parents tell News 8 that they're frustrated that the school district hasn't been more proactive in helping their son since he's been out of the hospital.